Welcome to Mentor Graphics Lesson, SystemVerilog Introduction to Classes. After completion of this lesson, you'll be able to define the terms class, object, handle, property, method, and member. Demonstrate where to put code in a class. Describe how to construct an object. And explain how to access the members of an object. Let's start with some OOP terms in SystemVerilog. A class is the basic building block of OOP. It contains or encapsulates related features and functionality. It has the definitions of the variables and the routines. For example, a transaction class has the data in the transaction and the code to manipulate that data. Now it's only a definition and no memory is allocated. An analogy is a blueprint for a house. It describes what a house looks like, but you can't live in a blueprint. Next is an object, which is an instance of a class. Memory is allocated when you construct the object. If you start with a blueprint and follow the plans, you will construct an actual house that you can live in. A handle tells you how to get to an object. It is the pointer. The handle for a house is its address. Property is just a fancy word for a variable that is declared inside of a class. You can think of it as the state of the object. This is a noun. In a house, variables might be light switches. Are they on or off? A method is a fancy term for a task or function in a class that manipulates the properties, both local ones and those outside. This is the verb that is the action for the nouns. In your house, you will turn light switches on and off. Together, properties and methods are known as the class members. So let's look at an example of a class. The class animal describes the characteristics of a real animal. Now, a real animal has many properties. Our example has an age and a name. Properties contains the values specific to an instance of this class, such as the name of the animal. The function new is also known as the constructor. It allocates memory and initializes properties. This will be discussed more later on. Methods operate on variables inside and outside the object. Now you can see how a class is a blueprint that shows what the object looks like. A class only contains definitions. All procedural code in a class must go in a method. Unlike a module, a class cannot have processes such as initial or always blocks, continuous assignment statements, or concurrent assertions. This example shows two recommendations. Look for the compass for more of these. Every class should have a unique ID, either a string or a number so you can tell objects apart. Most classes, especially those for transactions, should have a print method so you can quickly display them. How do you use the animal class? So here's the animal class defined inside of a module. First, you need a handle of type animal A_H. Initially, it is null and doesn't point to anything. Second, you need to create an animal object by calling the constructor. This allocates memory for the properties and initializes them. The constructor then returns the location. So now A_H points to the object. This course has a coding convention that handles end with _H. Your company may have a different convention. How do you access those properties and methods? In Verilog, you know how to make hierarchical references with instance names and the dot operator, such as top.i1.out. In SystemVerilog, you put a handle and a dot before the class members. Here's the animal class. First, declare the handle A of type animal. Construct the object. Now assign a value to the name property in the object. Call a task that works on the object's properties. And print the state of the object with your method. Now you can see the name and age of the animal object. Note these are dynamic references to the objects, not Verilog static references. If you change the handle A to point to another object, you will see different properties. Other OOP languages, such as C++ and Java, recommend that you never directly access a property, such as age, and instead create methods, such as getAge and setAge. In SystemVerilog, you are building test benches that need to inject errors, randomize variables, and other actions, so your test bench needs direct access to all the properties. If the property is hidden behind a getAge method, your test bench won't be able to easily modify it. In summary, in this lesson you learned to define the terms class, object, handle, property, method, and member, demonstrate where to put code in a class, describe how to construct an object, and explain how to access the members of an object. This concludes the lesson, SystemVerilog, Introduction to Classes.